Hi, I'm Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today in Betty's Kitchen, I have my daughter. This is Chelsea.
Hi.
And you probably know her already. But I've got her here because we are announcing a new cookbook. And here it is. So this is the Betty's Kitchen Collection, second edition. You'll notice on the counter right here, the first book we came out with is this one, A Year in Betty's Kitchen. That was the first year. A second year in Betty's Kitchen followed that. And then when we got to the third year, we thought this is going to be awkward doing a first year or a year in Betty's Kitchen, then a second year, a third year, a fourth year. So we combined all of these two with the new recipes of the third year and came up with a collection. And we're going to stick with that format until it doesn't work for us anymore. So that's why we have the Betty's Kitchen Collection Second Edition, which you'll see is a very thick book. It's larger than the book we had earlier. I don't know if you could tell that. But this book has 1,025 recipes, and 179 of those came from the last year. And this goes up through the end of January this year. So if you're looking for them on YouTube, anything after that won't be in the book, but it does add another year on to what we had, actually 13 months on to where we cut off with this cookbook. Now you can see what the front looks like. It's easily recognizable. And on the spine there's some information. On the back, there is information about the 1,000 recipes and the 179 new recipes. It gives all the categories that we have, like appetizers, drinks, and so on. And then it has a little bit of background material about me, personally, and a little biographical sketch about me, and another picture of me, surprisingly. But anyway, this cookbook, along with all the others, have been composed entirely by my daughter Chelsea. And that's why I wanted her here today to get you up on the cookbooks, or on this cookbook, because she's intimately familiar with every detail of the cookbook. And I think she made some changes, some very wise changes in indexing and things like that. So I'm going to turn it over to Chelsea, and she's going to explain to you some features of the new cookbook.
All right. Our previous cookbooks were working very well, but there were a few features that I thought could be enhanced a little bit. The main one being the bullets. As you can see in our previous cookbooks, we just listed all of the recipes, but this time we've added bullets to make shopping lists a little bit easier to make. And another difference that you will see is we numbered each recipe individually. And there were a few different reasons we did that. We thought it would be a little bit easier to find the recipes. This way, if you look in the index, which I will show you is in the back of the book, obviously, all of the recipes are listed by recipe number. And once you see a number, then you can find the recipe. And you don't just have to find the page and then find where the recipe is on the page, but this will lead you directly to the recipe itself. Another version we listed them by recipe number was we had our Kindle version of the cookbook in mind. And with Kindle, your page numbers don't always quite add up, especially if you change the font size and so on. So we thought just numbering all of the recipes individually would be a smart change, and I think it'll work out well. So let me get you a little bit more familiar with this cookbook. We have the title page here, obviously, and dedication and acknowledgments that my mother has made. And then we have the table of contents, fairly similar to our previous versions of the cookbook. We have the same categories that you're familiar with. We have just numbered them by recipe number instead of the page on which they are found. So, and Mom has written up a little preface here, some personalized information about Betty's Kitchen and how it got its start and so on. So we start with our first section here, which is appetizers. And the first recipe happens to be the first one that Mom ever uploaded to YouTube, the Quick and Easy Super Bowl Nachos. And they follow pretty much in that manner in the order in which they were uploaded, with a few little discrepancies here and there. But like she said, all of the recipes that she's done in the past 4 years up until January of this year are in this cookbook, so you can find it all. So when you get to a new section, you'll just see it starts with the new section name and continues with those recipes. One other thing I wanted to point out that I think is very helpful, several of the recipes have menu suggestions added. So if you find a recipe you really like, but you think, oh my goodness, what in the world will I serve this with? As you can see right here, we have a menu suggestion for this sizzling grilled beef strip steak. And Mom has added in that you can serve it with the twice-baked potatoes, fresh green salad, some French bread for a great meal, and don't forget the strawberries dipped in chocolate for dessert. So those are just little hints that she gives you if you want to just take her suggestions and make a complete meal out of it. And I've also left in all of the parenthetical information that she has added on YouTube, which a lot of people find very helpful. It tells which particular ingredient she uses. Say if there is a wide variety of tomatoes and you could choose any one, she tells you, well, I tend to use the stewed tomatoes for this recipe just because she thinks it works out better or whatever. But any kind of notes that she has, I went ahead and left that in the information. So it's more than just a strict listing of a recipe. It has a little bit of her personal touch on it as well, which I think is helpful. So that's pretty much the layout of the cookbook. It just continues on. I believe it's 440 pages. And it's all laid out very nicely, easy to read. And I believe, especially with the changes that we've made with this cookbook, everything should be very easy to find. So I briefly touched on the fact that this is available on Kindle version as well. Many of you might have Kindle ebook reading devices. We have one here, which will show you the cookbook as it appears on a Kindle. And very similar to the print version, obviously. And you can thumb through the pages here, and it has everything that the normal book has. So you start with your appetizers, and there's the listing. And it has the index in the back, and everything is very easy and simple to find. And for those of you who might not be aware, you don't have to have a Kindle in order to access Kindle books. There is a Kindle app. So if you have an iPhone or an iPad or even a PC computer, you can download the Kindle app and have access to the Kindle book on that as well. So let me show you here. I have an iPad as well. If you were to access Amazon, all you need to do is search for Bettyskitchen. And once you do that, this will pop up right here. You can click on the link for the cookbook here. And it will show you the page. Okay, this is the paperback, Betty's Collection, second edition, and it has the book description, about the author information, so on and so forth. And since it shows right here, I'll go ahead and touch on the price for the cookbook. We set it at $25, and there were a few reasons for setting the price at that amount. One being we had to make just a little bit of money, so we had to set it at that amount for it to be profitable at all. And plus, as many of you know, with Amazon, many times if you buy at least $25 worth of merchandise, you get super saver shipping, which means free shipping. So all you have to do is purchase this one item from Amazon and you get free shipping, at least in the US. I'm not really sure about other countries how that works, but at least for the US, you can do that. So that's very helpful. With the paperback version being $25, the Kindle version is priced at $9.99, so it is obviously less expensive. You can download it, get it within a minute or so. All right, and just to give you a little example of how you would use this cookbook, say you have some chicken available and you want to make a nice dinner for your family that day. So what you would do is you would go to the index section here in the back of the book, and you would go to the entrees, and you would find chicken. And as you can see, there are plenty of chicken recipes here in the cookbook. So Let's say the Swiss cheese chicken casserole catches your fancy and you think, I have some Swiss cheese on hand. That sounds like it might be good. It's recipe 380. So we would go in the book and here it is, Swiss cheese chicken casserole. And if you still think, well, I'm not sure exactly how that would turn out, or I'm not exactly sure how to make that if you're an amateur cook, you can just go to YouTube, type in Betty's Kitchen, and this exact recipe will be made by Betty. You can see step by step how it is made and how the finished product will look. And as I mentioned before, this cookbook can be found on Amazon.com. It can also be found on createspace.com, and that's www.createspace.com. And if you're familiar with Betty's Kitchen, you might know that my mom's previous cookbooks were all available through lulu.com, and that site was working out wonderfully for us. However, with the first year in Betty's Kitchen and the second year in Betty's Kitchen and then the collection that we had, many people were kind of confused by all of the availabilities, and they might have doubled up and maybe bought the collection as well as the first year, not knowing that it contained some of the same material. So what we decided to do was to streamline everything and get rid of any kind of confusion that there might be. So we're gonna keep those previous editions of cookbooks up for about 2 weeks or so on Lulu in case anybody wanted to make any last minute purchases of the previous cookbooks. But then we're gonna go ahead and cut ties with that site so there just won't be any confusion with any of our viewers. So these cookbooks will no longer be available on Lulu or anywhere else for that matter after about 2 weeks. So the place you will want to go to access my mom's newest cookbook is Amazon, and we chose that site because it's such a powerhouse in the industry. So many people are familiar with it, and you might want to make other purchases at the same time, and it can ship worldwide, and it's just such a wonderful site. So we're going with Amazon as well as createspace.com. They're kind of connected, so that's where you want to go to buy the cookbook. One last thing I did want to mention as an option for some of you who may be interested, and this is something we've never done with cookbooks in the past, but we're going to test the waters and see how this goes. Many of our mom's viewers have not only requested the cookbook, but they've requested to have a signed copy of the cookbook. And we are going to offer that as an option for the first time only. So if anybody would like a signed copy, all you have to do is send a total of $30. We're tacking on an extra $5 just to cover our expenses and postage and everything. But send $30 through PayPal to the address chelseelee@bellsouth.net, and that's spelled chelseelee at bellsouth.net. And if you send $30 to that address, then you will receive this cookbook in the mail, and my mom's signature will appear right here on your signed copy. So we're gonna see how that goes. Many of you have requested it, so hopefully that goes nicely, but if it's $30, if you're interested in that option. And also with the signed copy option, that right now is just for United States residents only. You know, maybe we'll open it up to international customers or viewers, but for now we're just gonna keep it in the US.
I'd like to say that I have really enjoyed the cookbooks that Chelsea has put together during the past 4 years, and I use them. It has become easier, like with last year's, having everything together. So since we had more recipes, just in case you might be interested, we have this book that will be easier to find some of the things from this past year. You won't have to go to the internet and look them up. If you like working with print material. I would like to thank all of you for your support in these cookbooks, because there has been a lot of interest, a lot of people asking lately, are you coming out with a new cookbook? And we tried to get the message out, yes, but we don't know exactly when, because it's time sensitive in that you have to wait until the publisher says it is ready, it is published. But it is ready, and I want you to know about it. I originally just wanted the first cookbook for me and my family, And I thought I would just kind of pass them out at Thanksgiving or something like that. But I decided, why not include my YouTube family? So that's why I'm giving you this offer. Don't feel obligated in any way, because you can always go to my channel and the recipes will always be there. I believe in giving you the recipe as well as the video. So hopefully some of you will enjoy this, and if not, I hope you enjoyed the video.